Hello, 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 y'all. I'm back. Because I couldn't not eat any longer with you guys. I just had to do it. So I am here today with a delicious, I'm famished as always. Nothing changes in that category. I'm always hungry and always starving and ready to mow down this food. So I'm always rushing the intro so I can. This is a spicy shrimp ramen with an egg mixed in. We'll talk about that in a little bit. And just some frozen broccoli that I steamed because I thought ramen is about the most unhealthy thing you can eat. So I might as well try to get some fortified nutrients in there while I can. I'm swallowing hard at the anticipation of this. The cats are, as always, everywhere, just mixing this around. So when I say egg, I don't make ramen very often. I eat it about once a year, maybe not even that much. But when I do have it, I like to crack an egg in the pot right before it is about done cooking the noodles, stir it up, and it kind of makes like an egg drop soup situation happening. And I coated it with tons and tons and tons of sriracha. So there's that. And the cats will be around, and so yeah, we'll talk in just a minute, but let me try a bite of this. I'm just gonna try the broccoli first. Oh, it's a little warm. The broth gives the broccoli a nice flavor. Ooh, it's spicy. Ha! Ah, lots of sriracha in there. Let me preface this by saying ice water. Let me preface this by saying that I'm gonna get it all over my clothes. So just disregard. I'm also in the weird stage of short hair to long hair. I know, receding hairline. I've just embraced it, but I'm growing my hair back out. There's Ripley. Hi, Nene. You want to come on camera? They love you. Please. She said, forget it. They probably will at some point. Okay, let's try these noodles. Now, I'm not going to lie. I'm pretty confident with my chopstick skills, but when it comes to noodles, I decay. We'll see how it goes here. But before we get to that, let's talk about what I want you to comment on, okay? So, let's see, what do we want to talk about today? I had this all on a list, and of course, it just like everything else in my world, just left my brain completely. Let's talk today, I do want to talk about the Beyoncé maternity photo shoot. What? What is going on with that? So, we'll get to that in just a second, but as for your comments, what do you think of Beyoncé's photo shoot, her maternity announcement? If you don't know what I'm talking about, go look it up right now and then tell me what you think. I posted on Facebook about it and the results were hilarious. And like I said on there, it was like straight out of a Sears Portrait Studio 1991 photo shoot. And I'm not dogging Beyoncé. I would dog anybody that did photos like that. Now watch, all her fans will destroy me. They're very protective over her. So, what do you think about that photo shoot? Hey, let's try this. Yum. Oh yeah, egg y'all. And actually, you know what? The noodles aren't as spicy as I would like, so hold on. We're gonna go, I'm gonna put some more sriracha in it. I'll just bring the sriracha back. One moment. Magic, we're back. I did get some soy sauce. Because there's not enough sodium in here for my liking. So just a little soy sauce, light sodium soy sauce, lighter. And the cat is looking at that like it's gonna touch it. She, so I'm gonna put that over there. And some more sriracha. This is just Aldi brand sriracha. And again, I've already put some in there, but it wasn't quite enough. I wanted it to be soups spicy. So now let's get all that mixed around. Oh, yeah. Ooh, and I love the big pieces of egg. And this is shrimp-flavored ramen. This is just your typical 13-cent a pack normal ramen. Now let's try. Much better. I've also got ice cream for this video. Halo top ice cream. You'll have to check, wait till the very end to see that baby. Should have brought a napkin. Just go ahead and disregard me now. So the Beyonce photo shoot, that was something. And I'm happy she's having twins. I'm happy for her. I just don't know that I would have done the photo shoot in that exact way. If you haven't seen it, it's I'm trying to think if there's a way that I can edit it in to show you guys. I'll try to put it in the thumbnail of this video. How about that? And you can see it. She has a whole album, but my favorite is she has this sheer something covering her. She's holding her belly, which is fine. But behind her, it's this 90s backdrop with this big, looks like somebody went to your uncle's funeral and took the flowers off the casket and just put it in the background of this photo, y'all. Like cheap plastic flowers. And maybe I'm just not deep enough to understand it. If you understand it on some sort of a spiritual level and it spoke to you, honey, let me know. And tell me what I'm not seeing. Because again, she may have had the best of intentions. That broccoli, y'all? In that broth. It's also raining. I feel like we should be telling scary stories. Like my credit score. So hopefully the power won't go out. Actually, if the power did go out, that would be very entertaining for video purposes. And I don't know about y'all, it's currently Wednesday. I probably won't upload this until tomorrow, maybe next week. I've got an Aldi video I might upload before this. At any rate, this has been one of those 3 days that felt like 14. Craziness at work. Insanity. I feel like I just come home. Last night I told Tony that I literally came home. I sent him a picture of my viewpoint, which was sitting on my chair over here, my coffee chair, and I was just staring off in space in pitch black, not speaking. And see, that's the thing, like my job is super social. I mean, I have to be on 24/7, and I love that, and I love my people, and I love being crazy wild, but I have to have my introverted time to myself as much, if not more, than my extroverted time. Is anybody else like that out there? And listen, I love all types. I love introverts. I love extroverts. I love combinations of the two. I have found, the older I get, that I am far more, excuse me, that sriracha hits right here. I have a little drink out of my Sailor Moon cup. I've found that as I get older, I am far, far, far more introverted than extroverted, and certainly more than I used to be. I love alone time and quiet time, almost to a fault. It's almost to where people don't even ask me to do things anymore because they know I'm going to probably say no. I did that just now for thumbnail purposes. Hi, Rippy. My mother will be so angry. Oh, there's the cat. One of the cats. That's Ripley, the white one. Come here. She'll get so mad at me if I touch the cat while I'm eating. She will text me and say, I saw that video. Get the cat away from you while you're eating. It's disgusting. Sorry. She lives here too. Don't you, Ripley. Say, I'm not dirty. I am a psycho about hair anyway, y'all. About cat hair. I I call them their treatments. Okay. Excuse me, the sriracha. I'm feeling the heat. I call them their treatments. And it's wipes that you can get at like PetSmart that are supposed to cut down on their shedding. And they're just like baby wipes. Well, I wipe them down every night. And they hate it. I do give them T-R-E-A-T-S. I can't say that because she will think that she's getting a T-R-E-A-T-S without the S. But it's, I call them their treatments, their shading treatments. Also brush them religiously and vacuum, don't I? Yes. Let's see if I can trick her to get over here. Ripley. Ripley. You want a treat? Treat? She's looking at me. Come on. Ripley. Treat? Come on. Come on. Shouldn't be me. Oh, and speaking of cats, as always, here comes Gray. Speaking of cats, I have made a litter box discovery. Y'all are gonna die when you think of how simple that is. So, Ripley, the white kitty, she has and had very good litter box habits in terms of she would go in the litter box, she would do her little cat thing, number one or number two, and she would exit. Fine. Gray kitty? No. She came into the picture, honey, and she flings that cat litter out like it done stole her man. Out of the litter box, into the hallway, into the room where I keep the litter, everywhere. Which makes me, the Joan Crawford in me, Mommy Dearest, crazy. I don't like that. So, I started to think to myself, there's got to be a better litter box option. And so I've been looking at the litter boxes with the lids. But I'm thinking, I don't want to pay $40 for a litter box. I already have two. So then I thought, you know what I do have a lot of? Big plastic tubs. You know, the big 30-gallon, maybe smaller, maybe bigger storage tubs that you put Christmas crap in and put it in your garage. I have so many of those. And I read a blog about this lady who made a cat litter box out of one of those boxes. But y'all, instead of doing a hole in the front of the box for the cat to go in, she put the lid on and then did the hole on the top. That way they go in, use the litter box, then they have to hop out, which prevents A, litter from flying everywhere because the hole's in the top and not on the side, and B, contains the smell better. So, I took a 30-gallon tote, put the lid on, cut it out. I put the box without the litter in the living room. Y'all, these cats lost their mind. They thought it was the coolest thing they had ever seen. They were jumping in, jumping out. They were playing with each other in there. It was adorable. I'll post a picture of that right now. So they, I hope I remember to do that. They absolutely loved it. And so I've got it up there now. I put fresh litter in there and I put it in the spot where their litter box is. And I know cats are weird, excuse me, about transitioning litter boxes, but so far, so good. They've done fabulous. And the cleanup is going to be so much easier. I'm so excited. Okay, let's get some more noodles here. That's a big old bite. That sriracha, y'all, is good. So, I'm very excited about my new litter box. Thank you very much, DIY. DIY, if you will. And if you have cats, I would highly recommend you trying it. Mine seem to love it. Y'all, the broccoli in that broth is so good. Ah, what do you think? Doing pretty good with the chopsticks, eh? I forgot a napkin, so just ignore me acting like a caveman. Like I didn't get brought up right. Do you all have babies? Fur babies? Real babies? I'm a new cat dad-ish. I've had Ripley about a year and Gray Kitty only about 3 months. Well, maybe not even that. 2 months? Maybe three. But do you have babies? Fur babies? If so, dogs or cats, what kinds? What kind of animals do you have? Growing up, y'all, my poor mother. My poor mother. We had dogs. We had cats. We had guinea pigs, sugar gliders, hamsters, gerbils, rats, chinchillas. The list goes on and on. 50-gallon aquariums with random fish. Not all at the same time, mind you. But I was on a very pet kick, I guess you could say, when I was growing up. Rat, did I mention a rat? I had a rat, y'all. His name was Templeton. And it was very smart, actually. Excuse me, actually. Used a litter box. Did you know a cat could use, or a cat, a rat could use a litter box? They can. Oh, I had a ferret. Had a ferret named Jenny. She lasted about, oh, I don't know, 3 days. She didn't die. When I got her, she hissed at me. I let her out of her cage to feed her and to play with her. She hissed at me, ran in the dishwasher, stayed there for 3 days. So I gave her back. I don't have that long of an attention span when it comes to pets. The cats I have done well. But y'all know how weird cats are when you first get them. I was convinced, oh my, this cat hates me, I'm gonna have to take her back. She hid under the couch for, I don't know, a solid 4 days. But now she loves me, and by that I mean she allows me to feed her and runs away when I try to pick her up. It's all about progress. Look, I'm getting down to the bare bones here. Now, dare I slurp the rest of this? I probably will. But I will try to be as, you know, not slurpy as I can. Just for you. And the thing is, with this egg, you can't even really taste it. It's not like big chunks of egg. They kind of dissolve. It just gives a extra richness to the broth. Mmm. Y'all, getting down to it here. I know, stuff's on my face. But I can't keep wiping it, to be honest. I just can't be bothered. Speaking of British accents, y'all, that show I was telling you about, The Fall on Netflix, oh. It's good, but let me tell you, they are drawing that storyline out. Every episode I think, oh, they're wrapping it up and it's going to be over. Y'all, I've watched like 9 episodes. There's still like that many left. I don't understand how they're going to do it. Okay. The time for niceness is over. I promise I will try not to slurp this, but I can't let this go to waste. Ooh. My mouth is on fire. Come on, Tyler, you got this. That's a shocker, shall that. Mmm. Okay. Let me pause this. We're going to take a little break, and we're going to come back. It's going to be ice cream time. So I'll see you in just a second. We're back, and it's ice cream time. I've had this before, but if you don't know about Halo Top, do yourself a favor and look it up, honey. Let me try to get some of the, can you see that? Halo Top. This is chocolate, the entire thing, 240 calories. And let me just read you the stats. 60 calories per serving. Servings per container, 4. So I'm gonna just tell you the whole thing because I'm probably gonna sit here and eat the whole thing. So 240 calories for the whole thing. 2 grams of fat per serving, or 8 total for the whole thing. 11 grams of carbs, or 44. Sugars, 4 grams, or 16 for this whole thing. 16 grams of sugar. And the ingredients are milk and cream, eggs, fiber, milk, organic cane sugar, high-fat cocoa. Interesting. I think that's what that said. Yeah. High-fat cocoa, huh. Vegetable glycerin, sea salt, carob gum, organic guar gum, and organic stevia. And this is the only spoon I have left in my house. I'm doing the dishes right now, and I just realized I don't have any spoons, so I'm using this huge, I don't even know what this is for, or why I have it. But sometimes you just gotta have chocolate ice cream, though. So good. I'm an ice cream snob, and that is so, so good. Oh, protein. I forgot to tell y'all that 6 grams of protein, or 24 grams of protein for this whole thing. Is that not amazing? Maybe I'll only eat half. Let's see. I got this at Kroger. They usually have it on sale for $3.99. If you get it other places, it's usually $4.99 or $5.99. If you've made it this far in the video, which here's hoping, do you feel the need to have something sweet after your dinner? I am that way to a fault. I've been that way my whole life. After dinner, you have something sweet. If so, what do you eat? Does anybody else eat ice cream? You get a bite, and you swish it around in your mouth. Cats are going insane. Swish it around in your mouth, and then you swallow it. Because I don't like it to be too terribly cold. Brain freeze, you know? Did y'all hear this? The cat races have begun. They do this every night. Dart back and forth like mad women. Tastes like ice cream, and that's the best compliment I can give it. I've had lots of faux ice creams. I'm kind of a connoisseur. That Arctic Freeze, have you heard of that? Please, give me a break. Chocolate in this. It's that high fat cocoa. Just need a minute. It's my ice cream. They're galloping. Come here, kitties. Come here, baby. Treat. Want a treat? Only Ripley likes treats. The gray cat will not touch them. And the reason for that is that when Gray Kitty was new and living in the laundry room because they were not getting along for the first week of their coexisting lives, she, the gray kitty, down in the laundry room, got an unopened bag of Temptations treats and ate every single one overnight. I opened the door to the laundry room that morning. She was just fat and laying there like in misery. And so I think she probably just doesn't ever want to have a treat again. Can you blame her? Maybe I should do that. I should eat like 12 gallons of ice cream and get sick, and then maybe I would never eat it again. I mean, honestly though, who could dislike or not like ice cream? You know, those people are like, oh, I can take it or leave it. Liar. You're lying. Everybody loves ice cream. Or they should. Oh. That was payback for being mean. Okay, y'all. I'm going to have a couple more bites. And then I'm going to put the lid on my container and put it back in the freezer. And by that I mean finish it off camera in one sitting. No, I'm going to try. I'm going to try to make it laugh. I feel like this is like precious gold. Because, good grief, even at $3.99, it's still very expensive. My fuck? Saving the rest. So good. Okay, guys. I'm going to wrap this up. We talked about Beyonce. Talked about cats. Talked about litter boxes. Talked about ice cream. Desserts. So, leave me a comment. Give me a thumbs up. Like, subscribe, and share my video to help me get out to the world, will ya? Hope you guys have a great day, and I will catch you guys next time. Bye.